But we're going to start tonight with Packers Mania. Good evening, I'm Toya Washington.
We can't
I'm excited.
That's right, I'm Gabby Michaelby. It is the night before the biggest game of the season so far, and fans are making that trip from Wisconsin to Dallas. They're arriving, getting settled. The team is also in Texas tonight.
And with them is our own 12 News' Shelby Croft, as well as Andy Kendi. And the feverish flair out there seems very playoff-like. Does that make any sense?
It certainly does. Yes, it does.
No, I know what you're talking about, Toya. Mm-hmm. This really does have a big game feel, a playoff-type atmosphere. And you know it's a playoff atmosphere, Shelby, when people start tailgating almost 24 hours before game time.
And we found them, and they were saying that word, Super Bowl, let me tell you that. You know, talked to so many people who got tickets to this game when the season first started, having no idea that both of these teams would come in here at 10-1 and this would be such a big showdown. You know, once they traveled down here, they found a place that feels just like home. Walk through the door of Vernon's Grill in Dallas, and it's more like walking into a bar in Green Bay.
This is the best place. This is as close as I get to Lambeau Field. It's right here.
It's awesome. You walk in, they've got a Green Bay Packers towel hanging up.
It's all Packers, from the memorabilia to the people tipping one back. No Cowboys fans.
They feel like they've been displaced.
Manager Gary Curlin doesn't mind shunning the local fans. Packer backers make up for it twofold.
They're diehards. They can be 4-12 or 12-4. It doesn't make any difference. I'll still have the same crowd in here.
Packers fans flock here like birds migrating south. It all started 14 years ago. A bartender from Wisconsin got green and gold fan clubs to come here, and it just grew from there. And this season, with their team at 10-1, these fans are getting vocal and confident.
Everyone.
It's going to be a great game. Playoffs are going to come through Green Bay.
The Packers are going to win, and my guess is 21-14.
This is the biggest moment of my life. I am so happy.
You know, a lot of people I talk to say they have been offered hundreds of dollars for their tickets to this game, but obviously the diehards say, no way, they're not giving this one up.
Yeah, priceless, right? Mm-hmm. Priceless. Yeah, the wait is almost over. Packers at 10-1, Cowboys at 10-1. This is just the second time since 1970 that two teams 10-1 or better meet this late in the regular season. This afternoon, Mike McCarthy leading his Packers into the team hotel here just outside Dallas. Relaxed the Packers are, even though they're a 7-point underdog. Maybe they're just too young to know any better. A huge game for a couple of rookies. A guy like first-round draft pick Justin Harrell. A golden opportunity for the defensive tackle to finally contribute.
It's definitely motivation. Like I said, we know what we're playing for, and both of us are 10-1. And like I said, just another game in the season and trying to get where we want to go at the end of the year. So definitely be a challenge for us.
Most likely both teams are going to the playoffs, so we might see each other again. But, I mean, we definitely want to win, and we're definitely going to go out here and play our best football.
That's rookie wide receiver James Jones. Who would have thought he'd make such a big contribution before the season started? And how about Ryan Grant, the running back? They got him in a trade, and he has been outstanding. How he's handling success, we'll talk about that coming up later in sports. And you notice the weather is perfect night for football, and it's going to be like this tomorrow night. They're talking about temps in the 50s and 60s. It's going to be a great night.
Oh, it is going to be a great day, great night all around. Reporting live in Dallas, Shelby Croft, Andy Kendi. Back to you guys.
And the Packers are due.